Hi everyone, welcome to this environmental studies and we are in module number 4. So the name of the module is Global Population Control. So in this we are in Global Environmental Concerns, that is the module that we are in. So in this Global Environmental Concerns, so what are the topics that I am going to cover in this video is, the first one is climate change, the next one is acid rain, and the third one is ozone depletion. So these three points are the three topics that most of them are familiar with, because in your early stage, so you might have studied about the climate change conditions and what is all about this acid rains and what is this ozone depletion and how the depletion takes place, what are the reasons for the depletion of ozone layer, and what are the remedies that you can take for this minimizing this depletion, ozone depletion. So we have already learned, but just for your understanding, so I'll just one more time I'll add some more light on this topics whatever I have mentioned here. So this is all about this climate change. So where you can see that a temperature change in the last 50 years, okay. Now we are in 2020, and from this 2010 to 2019, so for the past 10 years, so how that temperature changes takes place. So 2010 to 2019 average versus 1951 to 1978 baseline degrees Celsius. So this a red mark indicates that plus 4.0, that increase of degrees, a 4 degree increase of temperature. So that is what it is shown over here. And so the temperature, so where and all this red mark will give show that extreme amount of heat is that change, climate change happened in terms of temperature. Okay, so that is what you can see in the diagram. And climate change is a defining issue of our time, and we are at the defining moment, because of the deforestation and cutting of the trees, and construction of buildings and industries and automobiles and increase in population. So all are the things that are reason for this climate change. So that is we are in the time of issue of for time that we are at the defining moment. So from shifting weather patterns that threaten food production to rising sea levels that increase the risk of catastrophic flooding, the impacts of climate change are global in scope and unprecedented in scale. So without drastic action today, adapting to these impacts in the future will be more difficult and costly. So right now, by future, you can see the temperature rise. It is immense increase in temperature. If you are not concentrating, as far as this generation is concerned, if you are not concentrating on that shifting of this the weather patterns, then it will be very difficult for our future generations and the people of those who are going to come in future. So it is our own responsibility to make their generation so. The climatic, as far as the climatic is concerned, so it should be good, and we should give them a better climatic conditions in their lives. Now coming to this global warming, climate change, there is forest fires, different things are there for global warming, climate change. The first and foremost thing is like the industries, the carbon dioxide which are coming out from the industries, that is a major threat for all of us. And then the forest fires, and then tsunami, some natural calamities, and declassification, and soil eruption, and tornado. So all these things are the reasons that it will impact this global warming, climate change. So this is the major part is even some automobiles. So what we can say that automobiles are coming out from the poisonous gas. So that is also one of the reasons. So these are the main reasons for this global warming, climate change. The most thing which affects the climate, global warming, climate change is the industries, the carbon dioxide which is coming out from the industries. Now what are the causes and effects of climate change? We'll see what are the left side, there are the causes and the effects are given. So what are the causes? Rapid industrialization, energy use, agricultural practices, deforestation, consumer practices, livestock, transport, resource extraction, and pollution. So these are the causes for climate change and effects. rising temperatures, rising sea levels, unpredictable weather patterns, increase in extreme weather events, land degradation, loss of wildlife and biodiversity. So these are the effects for this climate change. So what are the social impacts of climate changes? Displaced people, poverty, loss of livelihood, hunger, malnutrition, increased risk of diseases, global food and water storages. So, social and economic impact of climate change, how does it affect social life and economical life, right? How does it impact? So, relocation of whole towns, this is what you call the social, what we are seeing, that relocation of whole towns and shrinking productivity of harvest, prices of basic foodstuffs and consumer goods will raise, extreme meteorological phenomena will cause widespread poverty, diseases will spread due to higher temperatures. Now, what are the social impact it will take on this climate change? Is the cost of adapting coastal areas to rising sea levels, loss of capacity to work due to heat, more wars to gain access to limited sources, fresh water will be in short supply in some areas. So these are the two impacts, right? Social impact and economic impact. Now coming to this acid rains, so much information is given. So in a very simple way, if you want to explain this, so there is oxides of nitrogen and hydrogen, so combined to each other, sulfur dioxide, oxides of nitrogen, and so there will be as a result, sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides are emitted into the atmosphere and transported by wind and air currents. So this sulfur dioxide, oxides of nitrogen react with water, oxygen and other chemicals to form sulfuric and nitric acids. So these then mix with water and other materials before falling to the ground. So this is nothing but the acid rain. Right, so burning of fossil fuel, how does it happen? The burning of fossil fuels to generate electricity. 2/3 of sulfur dioxide and 1/4 of oxides of nitrogen in the atmosphere come from electric power generators. Next one is vehicles and heavy equipment, and then manufacturing, oil refineries and other industries. So here we have seen that causes of acid rains, natural causes is volcanic emissions, biological processes and lightning. So next, anthropogenic causes is nothing but factories, that is industrialization, motor vehicles, automobile exhaust, coal-based power plants and domestic fires, smelters. So these are the chemical processes during the acid rains that you can see in the right hand side, chemical equations. And how to control this? So clean combustion technologies, using pollution control equipments, replacement of coal by natural gas and renewable energy resources, liming of lakes and soils, formulate the policy framework for reduction of sulfur dioxide and other acid rain causing gas emission, support a set of that sub-project that promote cleaner production, reduce acid rain and air pollution, improve the environment. So this is all about this ozone depletion. So sun's radiation, it is everybody knows about it, ozone depletion, sun's radiation coming and falling on the ozone layer. So straight away, and this the emissions which are coming out from our day-to-day usage, like carbon dioxide, chlorofluorocarbons, so hydrochlorocarbons, so all these things will come and will be the reason for this depletion of this ozone. So ozone depletion, gradual thinning of Earth's ozone layer in the upper atmosphere caused by the release of chemical compounds containing gaseous chlorine or bromine from industry and other human activities. The thinning is most pronounced in the polar regions, especially over Antarctica region. So here you can see from where and all this gases are emitted, from chlorofluorocarbons and deforestation and oil and petrol engines, and radiation absorbed by greenhouse gases and fossil fuels. So all these things, and some will be absorbed from the radiation and some will be reflected with the help of this ozone layer, right? So effects of ozone depletion, skin ailments will come, disturbed plant life cycle, destruction of marine life. So all these things will take place. So this is all about the acid rains, and in this video we have seen acid rains and ozone depletion. So let us take our initiative to make sure that switching over to, the best method is to switching over to renewable energy sources rather than non-renewable energy sources, because renewable energies will not disturb this atmospheric climatic change and this ozone depletion, thinning of these layers and all. So it is our responsibility to slowly shift one thing, and second thing is planting the trees, so making grow, so avoid the deforestation. All these things will bring changes in our lives. So this is what we can contribute from our end. So thank you so much for watching this video.